Hi, this is Kevin Thomas, and welcome to the At Home Cinema. This week, we're going to look at streamers' secret cinema. What does that mean? Well, every channel kind of directs you to pick a movie because they kind of follow your taste. Like, you might like this, you might like that, or featured movies of the month. Well, I'm going to go a little deeper than that. I'm going to find movies that are playing on streamers with really no fanfare. Movies like this, Lemon, which I was going to include as a secret movie on Hulu, but turned out I didn't really like Lemon. But I did like several others. In fact, I like so many, I might have to make a two-parter of this. But let's get started now. Our first movie is kind of a classic, actually, Fried Green Tomatoes, which you could find on Netflix. But there's no fanfare for you to watch it right now, and many of you who are younger may not have seen this really good movie that even got a couple of Oscar nominations. It's got Kathy Bates and Jessica Lange as more modern-day, yet older women, talking about stuff and becoming friends, and then Jessica flashes back and tells her story of some younger people that were played by Mary Stuart Masterson and Mary Louise Parker that had a great friendship. They were probably actually lesbians, but in those days you wouldn't say that term. The movie doesn't even say that term, but it did get nominated for awards for LGBTQ films, so I'm sure we all know they're lesbians. But even if you never heard of this movie because you're younger or never saw this movie, there is one famous scene that you probably have seen on social media. Let's watch that scene right now, okay? Sorry about the ring light, but I wanted you to see the whole screen or pretty much. Let's go. Another movie that is super classic is In a Lonely Place, which you could find on the Criterion Channel. It stars Humphrey Bogart. Now, I am not the biggest fan of his. I also don't dislike him. I could take him or leave him. But this movie is really good where he plays a murder mystery writer. And guess what? A murder mystery happens. And guess what? He is the suspect. He doesn't really have an alibi, so he relies on his neighbor, Gloria Graham, to help bail him out. She does, because she kind of has a thing for him, but she starts wondering, is he really that killer? Who knows? We're going to find out in this movie. Oh, based upon a book, the movie was very faithful to the book until the ending. So let's see what they dig up for this ending, shall we? Dance With Me on HBO is such a wonderful film. It was not even a hit when it came out at theater, so of course you may not have seen it even then. It stars Vanessa L. Williams, who I just love and adore, and the sexy young actor-singer named Cheyenne, who was very known at the time as well. But this movie, doesn't have a lot of fanfare for you to watch it on HBO, but it's a good dance competition movie. In fact, the person that dances with Vanessa Williams in the competition is actually a professional dancer who also professionally designed her clothes. It's a budding love story. It's a great dance movie. It's got good songs. There's no reason you should not dance with me or him. Oh, yes. B&B, which you could quietly find on Peacock and Hear TV, seems like a Swedish, not Swedish, but sweet-like movie. about a young gay couple that goes to a bed and breakfast, but they run into a lot of stereotypes when they get there because people there are not accepting of the gay lifestyle. They try to force them into a room with twin beds. They even publicly tell them they are against their lifestyle. The two men decide, we are going to fight back, but you know what? Sometimes you don't know what you're getting into when you get in a fight, and it's not all verbal battles, I will tell you. It is listed under horror genre. It's mysterious, it's menacing, it's more than just people against the gays. Oh no, watch B&B if you dare. The next movie I haven't seen, so I'm going to watch it with you. It's called Agatha, and it's on TCM, starring Dustin Hoffman and Vanessa Redgrave. Now, Dustin has a lot of movies on TCM this month, but Agatha is not getting the fanfare that many of the other ones are getting, so we should watch this because it's based upon a true incident where Agatha Christie goes missing for 11 days. People never really found out what happened. And actually, her family tried to stop this film from being made, but because it relies more on fiction than fact, they were not successful. I hope it's a good movie. I'm gonna find out with you, but I like the premise enough, so let's watch Agatha. I've talked about this movie before, but it was worth repeating because it was never a giant hit. The movie musical Hair, which you could find on Prime. It was a big giant Broadway success. It was also a big giant Broadway revival. For some reason, the movie never caught on, probably because maybe it was just too late to make it after the Vietnam War. But it's still vibrant, exciting, and fun. Treat Williams. He should have been up for an Oscar. Oh, I love this movie. Should have been up for an Oscar for Best Picture. It was actually directed by an Oscar-winning director, Milos Forman, who did One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. I don't know why it was not a hit. But you have to dig for your Prime to find it. But if you just hit the word Hair with the search engine, you will find it there and you could watch it for free. Oh, then on Paramount Plus, did we have a gem there? Ellie and Abby and Ellie's Dead Aunt. Oh, I discovered this movie a couple years ago at film festivals and I was so enchanted. And I am so glad you have the opportunity to watch it now yourself, especially if you got Paramount Plus. So it's about two young women in high school, maybe it's college. Well, but one of them is so shy, she doesn't know how to make the move to the girl that she likes. So somehow her aunt comes back from the dead and it gives her the encouragement and the support that she needs to make this happen. Oh God, when love happens, everyone's happy, especially Kevin. Oh, such a sweet movie. Well, that's our show for the week. I hope you enjoyed it. I will do a part two, maybe not next week, but soon. Until then, I hope you share and subscribe and tell your friends. And as we leave, let's watch the music video from the movie Dance With Me with Vanessa Williams and Cheyenne, shall we?
You are the one that I come to.
chemistry. See you next week. Bye.